In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the source of all mercy and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our sorrows so that we can comfort others in their sorrows with the consolation we ourselves have received from God. Thanks be to God. In holy baptism, Sally was clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all her sin. St. Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. If we have been united with him in his death, we will certainly also be united with him in his resurrection." We recite together Psalm 23, printed in the bulletin. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness to all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful to death and receive the crown of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. Our Old Testament lesson comes from Job chapter 19. Oh, that my words were written. Oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that with an iron pen and lead they were engraved in the rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, yet in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself. And my eyes shall behold, and not another. My heart faints within me. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our epistle lesson comes from Revelation chapter 21. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain any more, for the former things have passed away." And he who was seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." And he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the spring of the water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he will be my son." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the Holy Gospel. Our gospel lesson comes from St. John, chapter 14. Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. Dear Fred, Joy, and Rachel, and to all your family and extended family and friends and guests, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. I have to start by telling all of you something that is maybe a bit unusual about Sally. Obviously, some of the family knows because Fred is the one who told me about this. Sally loved to do laundry. She loved to clean the house. She loved to do the dishes. She loved to make sure everything was neat and clean. And I can tell you I'm in a bit of awe of that because I'm a little bit more of a messy person myself. Some of you who have seen my office, you know. But what a wonderful reflection of Sally's character. She liked things to be clean and neat and orderly. Sally also loved jigsaw puzzles. And I'm kind of wondering if this is related to her liking things to be neat and organized. I guess I would be curious, Fred, if you left a puzzle out that was uncompleted, would she want it to be done just so things were neat there in the house? Yeah, I think so. She also loved sewing and crocheting. She did a lot of cross stitch. Her family remembers this because she made some very special things for her family members, her grandkids. And I think those are wonderful things that you can cherish as fond memories of her. I can tell you also that Sally loved to be in church. For a while, earlier in her life, she played the organ. She was very involved in many areas of the life of the church, including teaching Sunday school, being in Bible study. I can still picture sometimes, Fred, when you would bring Sally to one of my Bible studies, and there you sat about halfway back on my right-hand side. Most of all, she longed to be in church. There were a couple of family members who told me that after speaking with her, as it ends up the day before she died, she ended by saying, "See you in church." What a sentiment. What a testament. I still remember one time in the past when I had visited her at home because she couldn't get to church. Fred wasn't able to bring her to church at that point. And she expressed regret to me that she wasn't able to be in church. And I told her, "That's okay. It's why I bring church to you." And she was so thankful to me, thankful for hearing God's word read and explained, thankful for receiving forgiveness of sins, thankful for being strengthened through Jesus' body and blood in Holy Communion. And I would say that is one of the biggest testaments of her character. She was not a complainer. She was thankful in the midst of the problems that she endured in life. She went through 26 surgeries. She had her neck fused sometime before I got here, so I never knew her being able to freely turn her head. And yet I never heard her complain. Fred and Joy and Rachel all told me that she was not a person who would grumble or mumble about anything. She suffered from numerous physical problems, and yet she endured with extreme grace and dignity. She was a woman of great grace. What a testament to her character that is, and also to her strength of faith. And because of that faith, her sentiment, "See you in church," has now been permanently fulfilled for her. She is in the church triumphant forevermore. And that has all happened because she is connected to Jesus' death, and even more importantly, connected to Jesus' resurrection. St. Paul reminds us of this in Romans chapter 6 when he said, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his." In baptism, the Holy Spirit connected Sally through faith to Jesus Christ. She is connected to his death on the cross, and she is even better connected to his resurrection on Easter Sunday, which we will celebrate just a short time from now. She is connected through faith to the love that Jesus has for her and the forgiveness of sins that Jesus gained for her. And for every one of us as well. She knew that Jesus died for her and all humanity. And therefore, the gates of heaven are wide open. Yes, Sally loved being in church. And she is now transported by God to the heavenly church for all eternity. St. John gives us a little glimpse of that, a little glimpse of the heavenly church in Revelation, in our epistle lesson. He says this, "Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will be with them as their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away." You see, God's desire from the beginning of creation is to have all of us dwell with him, to have Sally dwell with him. And when someone is within God's presence, there is no more sorrow nor crying, for the former things have passed away. And that includes for Sally. Her body will be healed, restored to the perfection as God intended it. No more physical problems of any sort for her, but rather only the joy and happiness of eternal life with Christ. This can give all of us comfort and peace. Knowing that Sally had strong faith and that she is at home in heaven with Jesus, we can have hope for the future because all of us, through faith in Christ, will also be reunited together with her and all the others who have gone before us in the church triumphant in heaven. Just as Jesus said at the very end of our epistle lesson, he said this, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the spring of the water of life without payment. The one who conquers will have this heritage." That is the heritage of Sally, the greatest gift of all. Through her faith in Jesus Christ, she has eternal life with Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Now may the peace that surpasses all human understanding guard and keep your hearts and your minds in the one true faith in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and that through the gate of death and the grave, we may pass with him to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith your Holy Spirit, that he may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give courage and faith to the bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the assurance of a holy and certain hope. in the communion of your church, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who have departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe in and find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Taught by our Lord and trusting in his promises, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. You may be seated. Before we process out, I'd like to introduce to you Joy, Fred and Sally's daughter, who'd like to say a few words.
So we have a gift here to represent how God is the giver of every good and perfect gift. And each one of you here today has been part of God's very good gift to us. So thank you for being here. God is the creator of all things. He is holy and he is in complete control. And God brings or allows all things in our lives as opportunities to get to know him more. And you know, we all know that my mom suffered a lot in this life. And at some point, we all suffer. But God uses our suffering, and he uses it to draw us closer to him. And when we suffer well, like my mom did, others see Jesus in us, and they are drawn to him. You know, our mom did not spend much time asking, why me? She didn't say, where are you, God? And God, are you real? Because if you were, you wouldn't allow this. We did not see her wallowing in self-pity. We didn't see her lashing out in anger at others or at God. Instead, like what was said earlier so beautifully, she accepted what God gave her with great courage, strength, and grace. We saw a reflection of her, of Christ in her. We also saw a reflection of Christ in our dad. And they were able to do this only because of the relationship with Jesus Christ. Our mom is with Jesus, and she is seeing him face to face. And she would want you to know is that 100% of what it takes to have your sin forgiven and have eternal life was paid for by Jesus Christ on the cross. We all sin, and our sin separates us from God forever. But when we turn from our sin and we turn toward Jesus, receiving God's forgiveness through Jesus Christ, God forgives our sins, and Jesus makes us right with God. So we want to ask, how about you? Do you also know that one day you will see Jesus face to face? As a family, it is our hope and prayer that everyone here today has accepted God's good and perfect gift of his Son, Jesus Christ, as your Redeemer. If you're not sure, or if you haven't, right now, we would ask that you take this opportunity and ask God to forgive you of your sins. You can tell him that you believe that Jesus is his Son who died for you personally. Then you're not separated from God anymore. You can have a personal relationship with the Almighty God who will never leave you, who will never forsake you. You can know him as your Lord, your Savior, and your forever friend. As you apply the Bible and get to know God through his word, you will grow in your relationship with God, and you too will look more and more like Jesus Christ. God has purchased the perfect gift for you. He's holding it out, but you must choose to accept it and to open it. So we ask, what will you do with the gift of salvation that God is offering you? Don't reject it. And thank you for being here. You sounded beautiful. The strength that we had from just hearing your voices was beautiful, so thank you.
After we process out, all of you are invited to join the family for luncheon in our gym, which is right back there. There is plenty of food, so please join in providing your comfort and your thoughts to the family and to each other after this time. Thank you.